Today, the number one fuse is answering your most important questions. All right, first question is from Abhishek Plays. According to you, should they decrease the knuckle cluster shooting time? Because sometimes in a close range fight, it's a disadvantage shooting the knuckles in the first place.
For me, like, the only disadvantage I would have, like, in the knuckle cluster is the animation and when you stick somebody with it. It takes a few seconds for it to explode and along with the animation. So it's always best to be in a situation where you don't expose yourself to somebody up close.
All right, we got a question from Juan Cruz. With his class buff with carrying more ammo, I've been using the extra space for more grenades. You think this is a good idea to use his buff like this?
Honestly, I actually love his buff. Ever since the buff came out, you know, it's enabled me to stack up with more grenades. So
so he's doing the same thing that you are, which is good.
Yeah. It's passive.
All right, we got a question from Derpy Squid. When do you think he will get his heirloom, and what do you think it will slash should be?
Hopefully his heirloom comes next season or the season after that. Honestly, Fuse does have a pretty low pick rate, and his heirloom, there was this Reddit where I saw somebody said that if he had a flaming boomerang and then they have an animation where you throw the boomerang and when it turns to you, it gives you the beer.
Brings you a beer?
Or another one. Yeah, a beer. That'll be a pretty awesome one. Or a fail with a spike grenade with it. I think it'll be pretty awesome.
Okay. All right, we get a question from Ice Ian. What do you think about the people who say the only Fuse mains are middle-aged dads?
Really?
Apparently, that's what they're saying.
That's pretty new to me. I mean, I'm 27 years old, so I can't really say anything much about that. I know, shout out to V Hydro play and Match, and you know, I know Match is almost on his 30s. Shout out to them. Much love for them. one of my friends actually told me there was this Fuse who's from the Navy and he's on his 30s. He's like pretty buff dude.
Really? Do we know how old Hydroplane is?
Hydroplane? He had to be on his 24. I say 24, 25.
24, okay. All right, I don't think there's any Fuse mains under 24, let's say. Let's give Hydroplane the benefit of the doubt. Every other Fuse main's older than 24.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, we got a question from Or Mr. 10. What grenades should you prioritize and how many of them should you be carrying with Fuse?
You always want to prioritize on thermites, arc star, and grenades. I find each of those grenades are very situational. For example, you know, since Fuse have the ability where you can actually toggle to use throw the grenades regularly, it helps out a lot of situations. Say if somebody's in the high ground, you can utilize that to go for a sky nade. The arc star, I love using the arc star in mid to close quarters, because not only that it forces people to get out of cover, but you get a sticky grenade if you stick them with the arc star. Oh, that's honestly a win right there. And it's also devastating damage that there's a team next to them too. With the thermites, I always use the thermite as a temporary aerial denial along with the knuckle cluster. Say somebody's pushing it real hard, or if there's a knock, I'll use that to either block it or deny the res. It's like Fuse kit alone just applies so much pressure.
Okay, let's say there's a situation where you can only pick one of them up. What one would you pick? Or is it, like you said, purely situational where, let's say they're above you, you take a frag or et cetera?
Frag grenade. To me, the frag grenade is a must, especially fighting somebody in the high ground. It would be a frag grenade because since I had the knuckle cluster with me, I could use the knuckle cluster with variety of things, you know, such as, you know, using that as a temporary proximity mine to explode and muffle my footsteps, or use that to block a choke or chokehold temporarily.
Okay, that plays into our next question from Curveside. Do you think Fuse's knuckle cluster should do more damage when hitting someone directly?
The way I like for Fuse to have his knuckle cluster work, if you stick somebody with the knuckle cluster, it should detonate sooner and the airburst should be more compact.
Okay.
Versus how the knuckle cluster is regularly. You stick somebody, you hit somebody, it sticks to whatever surface it is, and it takes like a few seconds for it to detonate. But in my opinion, if you buff his damage, it's gonna be broken. There's situations where I'm able to hit people up to 40 to 60 damage with one knuckle cluster.
All right, I don't think this question was asked in the screenshots that I got, but what would you currently rate him right now?
I'd give Fuse a B-. It takes some time to get used to when you see Matching, for example, and how he utilizes the Fuse. Fuse is more like a brawl, so he doesn't really have any kit to get out of the way.
Hobby Vinny asks, what is the best way to use his ultimate, and would you grab more nades because of his passive?
Yes, actually, I've been finding myself, depending on the backpack you have, say you have like the level one backpack, I say, you know, you can grab up to 2 to 3 grenades, or maybe 4, and so on with the other levels of the backpack. But what makes Fuse and the passive really strong together is the gold backpack. You can stack up 3 batteries and 3 med kits in one stack. You can go nuts with it. You could be a literal walking AC-130 with that.
All right, what about his ultimate?
There's a little trick that I always use ever since he got the buff for his ult where he can scan. Whenever there's a respawn ship that comes in, you shoot the respawn ship up. So the higher his ult, the wider is going to be his scan. It's actually strong enough to outdo Seer and Bloodhound's ult altogether. It's insane.
I believe I saw a clip where you did that you sent to me.
Yeah, okay. I also have one with you can also use that on Valkyrie's ult. They patched it the last 2 seasons where you can shoot his knuckle clusters up in the air, and along with the knuckle cluster or whatever grenade he has, you shoot up in the air and aim at it with the mother load. It will be the same thing with the respawn ship and Valkyrie's ult. The higher, the better.
The Valkyrie ult you're talking about, where do they have to be? Flying straight up or flying above you?
At his peak, flying straight up.
Okay.
As long as you within range.
Is that if you have your team, useful though?
It's insane. You combine that with Valkyrie's ult, it'll have a huge scan. And plus, if I'm correct, her scan radius is 200 meters. So it can scan anybody who try to come to third party and someone who's in the close area. Like, nobody can escape from that.
Okay. I'm having trouble understanding, like, so you're talking about a Valkyrie is on the other team, correct?
It could be your teammate's Valkyrie or it could be the enemy Valkyrie.
Okay. So let's say your teammate goes up with a Valkyrie ult. You can shoot it at your own teammate.
Yeah. Getting a wider scan on anybody. On top of that, he's going to scan anybody who's not in a fight. Say, for example, if there's like 2 or 3 teams that's going to come in for a third party and there's like 3 or 4 teams fighting in, that's 7 teams in that area that you're scanning. It's actually big enough to scan the whole antenna area in Stormpoint.
Wow, that's pretty good, especially towards end zone.
He's a ticking time bomb. If you give Fuse any time to cool down, you're gonna be in trouble.
Very true. That actually goes well into our next question from Senior Smazlock. Best legends to pair with Fuse. I'm gonna guess you'll say Valkyrie still.
Several legends, actually. You know, Horizon with her black hole, Caustic with the Nox gas, Gibby with his artillery strike, Bangler's ult, Crypto's ult. It goes well with everybody, especially the movement legends like Octane's jump pad, Horizon's lift.
Do you like to have a legend that can get you to high ground on your team?
Oh yeah, definitely. I find myself relying on either Pathfinder's zipline or Horizon. It helps a lot. I love having a Lobo with me. That way I can stack up more nades. Since because of his passive, I could take 2 grenades in 1 stack.
Okay. All right, we got a question from Untamed Dragon. How often do you run through your knuckle clusters or ultimate, and is it on purpose or not?
I use my knuckle cluster for many variations. Not only when I use it for a gunfight, I also use the knuckle cluster to aim at the enemy's general area. Since it's very loud, you can actually sneak up behind them.
All right, we got a question from David. What's your favorite gun combo to use with Fuse?
Normally, I always use the Car Wingman or the Prowler Wingman. He excels a lot in long and mid range. So you can use any long range from the repeater, the G7, the longbow, and paired up with a close quarter SMG, like, you know, the Car and the Prowler.
I do remember you are a big Wingman fanatic. A lot of the clips that you sent me the last time were with that Wingman.
Oh man, I love the wing, man. I feel like Dante from Devil May Cry when I use it. Jackpot. I end up using the Wingman a lot just because of ACU. When I've been seeing him using it, it's like, God, this guy is a maniac with it.
Oh yeah. Very rewarding when you hit your shots with it. I got a question from Bruno. Do you think Fuse is good for ranked, and can you feel it in your stash?
Yeah, honestly. From my experience, you'll normally see a lot of defense legend like Kossack, Watson, and normally it'll be hard to actually fight them, or they'll delay the fight and the team to come in. Fuse really make rank a bit much easier. You know, me personally, the way I always use Fuse, I always use them as a aggressive slash defensive playstyle. So in rank, you know, if you're facing a defense legend team, you always gotta prioritize. If they have a Watson, you always gotta prioritize and destroying their pylon. Once you destroy their pylon, you can harass them with the knuckle cluster, destroy all the traps they have, and apply more pressure. And also, it helps a lot with a team comes in, because you know, when you're in rank, especially in pred lobbies, you know, the longer the fight is, more teams gonna pull up.
100%. All right, we got a question from Gabe. What is the best way to play Fuse indoors?
The best way to play Fuse indoors. There was a clip where Machin had mentioned about door slap. It's a tactic where if you're holding the door, if you and the person on door to each other, you have a better advantage using the door slap. I call it breaching. All right. When it comes to playing the door, if there's a team that's full on aping the building, you want to shoot the knuckle cluster or the nades on each side, especially if you're in a situation where your teammate is knocked. You gotta be mindful from using this ult. Since you're inside the building, you don't want to catch yourself in the situation where you get hit by the tick and it'll screw you over. So you gotta be mindful with it.
All right, question from Mr. Steel. Do you prefer using the strong grenade throw or the normal throw, and why?
It depends, really. If I'm shooting somebody a long distance, it's gonna be like the strong grenade. Arcstar, I always use the strong grenade on the Arcstar. It's a must for me. I always have a tendency to shoot the Arcstar directly at somebody or shoot it right next to their foot.
Cherry Bloom wants to know what you think if Fuse's heirloom was his arm.
I mean, shoot, if Fuse's arm would heirloom would be like the gorilla arm, shoot, I would love it. You know, this straight up give him a straight uppercut, seeing them flying.
Imagine that was his leg ability. That sounds a lot like, what was that legend, that Forge?
Yeah,
that never Forge, got.
Forge was actually going to be a legend I wanted to main, because me personally, since I play Street Fighter, I play a lot of Street Fighter games, like, you know, Mortal Kombat, Tekken, Street Fighter. So I always have a tendency of milling somebody. If Forge were to be for real instead of Revenant, you know, Forge would actually been my main legend.
Wow. Okay, we might have seen number one Forge here instead of number one Fuse. Do you think Fuse is the best in the assault class?
I would say he's the best of the assault class. You know, there's other legend who brings more to the table, like Revenant's ult and his silent. I think his kit is very powerful. Having the ability to prevent them from using their abilities is crazy. Ash and Maggie is pretty good. Those assault legends that bring more to the table than Fuse. It depends on the situation. Revenant can excel at things that Fuse can't do. You know, same thing goes with Ash and Maggie in Bangalore.
Everybody's better in one category or another. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. All right. Play Counter FPS. If you could change something about Fuse, what would it be?
One thing will be his ult. You know, there's situations where I would hit somebody with my ult and then I'll just see a straight damage of 5, but it doesn't slow them down or anything. You know, I would love for his ult to, like, would it travel faster, or where the wall of flames are like a little taller.
What if the wall of flames were so high you couldn't get out?
Oh my goodness. Sometimes you just gotta run through it. You either run through it or you just get blown up by his arsenal.
That would be definitely like something to see.
Like I said, Fuse is a walking AC-130. You gotta be careful with him.
All right, Hanma. That is that's all the questions that I screenshotted today. What else would you like to add, if anything?
One thing I would like to add is, you know, be very mindful when you're 1v1 in Fuse. And like I said, don't give Fuse any opening. Fuse excel a lot when he's in the high ground or when in open area. If he catches you in the open area or when you're behind cover, you gotta be mindful for him.
What legends do you struggle against, if you don't mind me asking?
I do struggle against Horizon because, you know, due to her ability.
Yep.
When I shoot my mother load, she'll pull up the left and then, you know, she doesn't get the stun penalty.
All right, brother. I think that's all we got for today.
I wanted to make sure I make some, you know, some fire content. You know, I want to make the other Fuse players proud, you know.
That's
and behind your plane, you know, Raps Bone, shout out to him, much love for the brother.
You got
to
carry on the legacy since Match stopped playing.
I don't want to forget about, you know, the other Fuse, like It's Red and Orbit, man. Much love to my Fuse mains, yo.
Hell yeah, bro.